In biology, regeneration is the process of renewal, restoration, and growth that makes genome cells, organisms, and ecosystems resilient to natural fluctuations or events that cause disturbance or damage. The ability to regenerate is widespread in the animal kingdom, with representatives for most animal phyla displaying the ability to regrow missing body parts, except mammals or humans, because we are so lame. Hi, I'm Sophia, and this is The Biologist Apprentice, in English.
Planarians are 2 to 20 millimeters in size and have a complex anatomy with around a million cells. They live in freshwater ponds and streams around the world. The worm's genome has been sequenced, and its basic biology is well described, making planarians very popular with scientists.
But honestly, I'm not the best person to talk about planarians, so today I have a very incredible guest. Please welcome Dr. One Pagan.
Hello everyone. I am Dr. One Reinaldo Pagan, and I'm going to talk about planarians. First thing that we want to talk about is what exactly are planarians. Planarians literally means flat worm, and they are deceptively simple animals that display a lot of very interesting characteristics that make them amenable for scientific research. I'm a little biased because I use them in my own research, but they are very cute. Scientifically though, they display relatively complex behaviors. They are sensitive to many drugs that act upon humans and other vertebrates, and they display a very important characteristic. Many species display an unusual capacity for regeneration. That makes them very special because in many species, they are the most efficient animals at full body regeneration among animals with a centralized nervous system, meaning that if you cut a planarian in any, virtually any way, it will regenerate its own body given time and if you take care of them, including their brains. No animal that possesses a brain is able to do that.
The ability of animals to regenerate missing parts is a constant subject of study in biology, because the sources of new cells for these regenerative phenomena have been researched for decades. Recent advances involving cell fate tracking in complex tissues have shed new light on the cellular underpinnings of regeneration in Hydra, planarians, zebrafish, xenophus, and the axolotl. But how exactly planarians regenerate?
And they are able to do that because they possess a version of stem cells. They are called neoblasts that only one of them, when present in a planarian, it's enough to endow the organism with the capacity of regeneration. There are many scientists who are studying planarians in order to discover their secrets. But can you imagine if we learn how to regenerate a brain correctly? Think about people with brain injuries from car accidents or Alzheimer's disease or any type of brain insult. If we learn how to regrow a brain correctly, it could benefit humanity immensely.
As we can see, regenerative phenomena in the animal kingdom involve differences in the number of cell types to be made, ranging from replacing a single cell type to replacing all the cells within a region of the body. Since the late 1800s, scientists have studied these worms to better understand fundamental principles of natural regeneration and repair, information that could provide insights into tissue healing and cancer.
Now you know! These very cute cross-eyed flatworms are nature's little wonders with great abilities of regeneration.
Thank you, Sophia. It's been a pleasure talking to you today. Say hello to all your viewers. Bye!
Thank you to Dr. Pagan for joining me in this video. If you want to know more about planarians, be sure to visit valscience.com. And if you want to listen great science, please check out the Val Sciences podcast. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow me on my social media. You can follow me at Sofia Biologista, and I'll see you in the next video.